The Pinoy indie film Nino bagged the top prize in the new current category of the 16th Busan International Film Festival in South Korea. It is the first Filipino film to win the festival's Best Picture honors. The movie depicts a family drama set within the world of opera, with its haunting arias and pained hopes in rekindling a celebrated past. Let's take a sneak peek at the indie film Nino.
This is such a huge loss. How do you manage?
We make do with what we have.
Napaka-impractical itong ganito kalaking bahay. Bakit hindi mo na nga lang ibenta?
This house is not for sale!
Ibenta niya ito, ma'am.
Ang Villa Los Reyes Magos. Tayong uli.
Ang brilliant itong bahay ito noon. Yung era una ako, ganda finado. Nakumumpit na kita mo sana ako.
Ibabalik ko din agad, ma. Kasi dumarating yung pera ko galing sa Davao.
Bakit ano bang makalam mo sa akin? Yaya ng bata at ng lol niya.
Kamukha mo! How old are you?
Oh, how old are you now?
Ang gusto mo, babayaran lang ang mga utang mo!
Nino, doon ka sa kwarto ni Lola mo.
Ma, huwag mo nga tawagin Nino yan.
Nino, Nino, bonito, ikaw, Nino, Nino!
The film Nino earned kudos from the 2011 Busan Film Fest for its good script and great interpretation. Now here to tell us more about the film is the writer, Roddy Vera. Good morning, Roddy.
Good morning.
Okay, that must be a nice pat on the back. Well, first of all, congratulations, of course, on bagging the prize, or the film bagging the prize at the Busan International Film Festival. But it must be a nice pat on the back na pinansin in particular yung an area where you have a very active role, which is the writing. Yeah. How does that make
well,
you feel?
Welcome surprise para sa akin. Mm-hmm. I mean, I wasn't expecting anything when Loy went to Busan and right. I heard that it got into the new current section. Mm-hmm. But then I got this text and suddenly, sabi nananalo daw. Wow, sabi. That's good enough.
But I mean, that's great for everybody in the film. When a film, I mean, obviously a film is very much a collaborative effort from all sorts of from various minds and talents that take part. But your area has been praised in particular, so that must be nice.
Well, I guess it's because it's not just the what I contributed to the film, but mm-hmm. also because the way the film was made, mm-hmm. Loy is very very open. I liked him as a good director because mm-hmm. he creates this environment, mm-hmm. you know, where people, even actors, you know, can give their own ideas, can contribute their own ideas. And what I did was, of course, we brainstormed on the story, mm-hmm. and then after that, we listened to the feedback of the actors on right. first reading.
Okay.
We had a first draft.
Okay.
And all of them gave their own contributions, the way they understood their characters, and that did a lot.
So no. this is not some great story that you've had, that you've kept bottled up for the longest time, and that finally, mailalabas ko na tong kwento na gusto kong mailabas. You know, this is a story that was born out of a great collaboration of various people.
Right, yeah. We started with kasi kami ni Loy, no, when we brainstormed, mm-hmm. this is the second that we brainstormed.
Right.
And nato kami sa Tagaytay, and then we were just looking at each other and saying, mm-hmm. oh, what are we going to do? We had to do something for Cinemalaya.
Right.
And for 2 days, we couldn't come up with anything. All he said was there was this Santo Niño that he's so fascinated about. Mm-hmm. And so we started from there.
Okay. The setting itself, I mean, it's essentially a family drama, you know, as I understand it, a story of how the different characters interact with each other set within the setting of the family. But it's set against the background of a grand mansion, sort of shadow of what it formerly was, a house
Correct.
In decay, reflected in some of the characters also who are sort of hanging on to their past glories.
Right.
But opera, it's sort of, that's not something you'd usually see in
Philippine,
quote-unquote, a typical Filipino movie or setting. Where did that come from?
Over breakfast.
Okay. That must have been some breakfast you guys had.
No, sabi ko, why not opera? We both love music.
Mm-hmm.
And immediately, actually, even before we started doing the story, Fides came to mind, mm-hmm. Fides Cuyugan. And
yeah.
I said, you know, why not use her as a character. Mm-hmm. And she got really excited. Okay. And, you know, the story developed alongside, you know, her own suggestions and all that.
Uh-huh. Okay, well, tell us a bit more about, you know, the broad strokes of the story and how the story develops.
Well, this whole mansion is called Villa Los Reyes Magos. Mm-hmm. No? It's called the Three Kings. No, kanya lang, dalawa na lang sila, mm-hmm. at yung isa babae, si Celia and si Gaspar. And they're very old and they have their children. You know? So, she used to be an opera singer diva, and the Gaspar, the elder brother, used to be a congressman. Mm-hmm. But now everything is crumbling, mm-hmm. and now the children are taking over, mm-hmm. and the whole question is, what's going to happen to the house? It's going to be sold. People, you know, they can turn this into condominiums and townhouses and everything, and malls, etc. Mm-hmm. And so, the decisions of the children are crucial to what will happen to the whole house, mm-hmm. and also to the family itself. Mm-hmm. And central to that, all around that, this little boy, mm-hmm. Who's in Santo Niño outfit, is looking at the whole
thing. Where does that come from? The fact that you have this little boy in a Santo Niño outfit. What role does he play here in sewing the story together?
He's actually the silent, innocent observer, mm-hmm. of what is happening, mm-hmm. and towards the end of the film you begin to realize this boy doesn't know what's going to happen to him until probably he gets a little older, which is not in the film already, mm-hmm. and he will see what happened to his family because he's the third generation, mm-hmm. in, mm-hmm. that family.
Okay, I mean, you said it was sort of very much a collaborative effort and the story developed from there, but you said that much of it is drawn from your inspiration because of your love for music and that sort of thing. What other ingredients, so to speak, come into play in this film that you guys wrote? I mean, what were some of the influences and inspirations for the characters and storyline here?
Well, for one, you know, started with Loy's fascination for this Santo Niño. He saw this huge Santo Niño parade, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. 3 years back.
Right.
And he said, let's develop a story on that. So it started with, you know, an old woman and the young boy.
Okay.
You know? So, and then, dahil nga sa pumasok yung idea ng opera, that's where it began to grow to more than just being the Santo Niño. Mm-hmm. And the Santo Niño became more like a metaphor, and at the same time layered with different other unknown. But what Loy and I were really more concerned about were the characters that were beginning to grow.
No? Okay.
I mean, yeah, she's an opera singer, but what is she really? What does she really want? Mm-hmm. And who are her children? And the children, the daughter of her elder brother. No? Mm-hmm. So we were more concerned about how they would relate to each other at the time that this house is becoming the main problem.
Okay, this is like a good storyline 101 happening right over here. But as a writer, how does it feel when you finally see, you know, your work, it's finally there, and it's translated from something you've written out on a piece of paper onto, nowadays it's hardly celluloid, but I mean, you know, on screen. How does it feel as a writer to see, oh, there it is, I wrote that, we wrote that?
Yeah, I mean, I was there in some parts of the shooting, mm-hmm. and I was really very the whole picturization of the scene. No? Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's not how I imagined it, mm-hmm. but then when
how does that make you feel when it's not quite what you imagined it?
Well, both positive and negative at some times. Mm-hmm. Minsan pag nakita ko, ay mas maganda dun sa naisip ko, no? Parang ganon. No?
All right.
Or minsan naman, and then I come go to Loy and say maybe, you know, you can do this or do that.
Okay.
And then, because we keep on communicating, mm-hmm. you know, and sometimes he's not quite sure, mm-hmm. about how to approach this. And so we think about
you
it.
You work it out. Yeah. All right, well, that's really cool. Thanks for giving us a sneak peek into how this film came together. Congratulations again to you and Direk for this great achievement, taking home top prize in the 2011 Busan International Film Festival. Is there going to be a chance for everybody else to see the film? Is there going to be a mainstream showing?
There might be a commercial run, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. In the future.
Right.
They're already figuring it out.
Working out.
Maybe
the
that's where the prize money will go.
All right, well, good stuff. Once again, congratulations, and thank you so much for joining us this morning, Roddy.
Thank you.
All right, still to come, folks, Caroline.